y'all. Welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me. I want to talk to you today about some of my favorite products that are natural. It is very difficult to find good products that I like that are natural. So I want to share the ones that I'm using right now that I love, and all the products that I have here, I will put a link below so that you can see what they are. And if you want to purchase them, great. If not, great too. So the first one is a toothpaste that I'm absolutely loving. This toothpaste is a whitening toothpaste. It's called Himalaya Bantanique. I think that's how you say it. Himalayan Bantanique. I will put a link below so you can see that. It's hard to kind of get that to focus in the screen. But this toothpaste, the thing, what happened to me is I have bought this toothpaste by Jason's, and Jason's is a natural toothpaste brand. I've never had a problem with Jason's. I've bought them for years, but there was this particular one that I bought, and I paid like $5 for it, and it was disgusting. Oh my goodness, it was so nasty. But I didn't want to waste my $5, and I didn't want to put it in the trash, so I used it, and it seemed like it took forever for me to actually finish the toothpaste. And so when I finally finished that toothpaste, I was like, I am going to find another toothpaste that I like that tastes really good and is that is even more natural than that one that I had. And so there are toothpastes that are more natural than this. This one has quite a few ingredients in them, but nothing negative. It is no bad things in this toothpaste, but it is a whitening toothpaste, and I'm always getting compliments on my teeth. They say, how do you keep your teeth so white? It's not anything special I'm doing. I'm telling you, I'm like the worst with tooth care. I brush my teeth once a day and sometimes twice, and that might sound really disgusting, but you know, my husband, he's one of these people, he brushes his teeth like 3, 4, 5 times a day. Like anytime he puts anything in his mouth, he's in the bathroom brushing his teeth. I'm not like that. I didn't grow up like that. And as a matter of fact, when I was a kid, if somebody didn't tell me to brush my teeth, I probably wouldn't have. I'm sorry for him. I'm like so embarrassed for admitting that to all of you, but that's the truth. So this toothpaste actually does really clean my teeth. It doesn't taste disgusting. It doesn't have any bad chemicals in it, and I'm loving it. As a matter of fact, when I'm done with this one, I will buy it again. That's how much I like it. And I've been bouncing around from toothpaste to toothpaste trying to find one that I really like. The first time I tried it, I didn't like it. I didn't like the way my mouth felt, probably because I was so used to using that nasty teeth toothpaste that I had bought by Jason's, that the second time I used it, I was like, oh, I actually really like this. So I'm recommending this because it really does clean the teeth well, doesn't have any really nasty ingredients in it, no fluoride. It's a good toothpaste. And I'll put the link below for this one. The next one here is Pacifica Glow. It is a, don't know if that is actually focusing or not. I'm not having a good day with focusing the products, probably because of the light. But this is a scrub. This is a youthful face scrub. And one of the things, if you have dry skin, or if you have acne prone skin, or if you have acne scars like I do, like I don't have any more acne on my face because I had acne really bad, but I have struggled with acne scars my entire life. And this scrub is gentle enough to where it, you know, exfoliates my skin. It smells good. Let me see if I can show you what it looks like. It smells good. And it's like a paste almost. And I use it every once in a while. I'm not a scrub person every day, but I do use a scrub brush on my face like every day, and an exfoliator. And I think I might have shown that in another video. But this particular product, if you're looking for a scrub, they usually sell it in like Ulta or Target. But I'll put a link to this exact one, especially since I'm having trouble actually focusing the name of these products for some reason. So that's another favorite. Now, my absolute favorite for this particular product, video is this one. This is by Tarte. It's called Flawless, and it is a primer for the face. And one thing I found about this is your makeup will not move. It will be on your face all day. And it's hard to find a natural product that actually does that. This is a good brand. It's a vegan brand. I don't know if you're looking for vegan brands, but it's definitely better than some of that silicone-based stuff that they have in the stores that are clogging up our skin and making us toxic. So this is a good product. It's expensive. I can't remember how much it costs, but it has lasted me a very long time. I've had this a very long time. So if you purchase it and you're looking to justify the cost a little bit, it lasts a long time because a little bit goes a long way for this. Mascara. I like this mascara because I have little tiny eyelashes. It's by Pacifica. Look at that. I can't focus it in there. I'm so sorry. This is a mascara. It helps lengthen my eyelashes and it makes them look a little bit thicker. This is the one I'm using right now. I bought this at Target and I'll put a link for this exact one. This one's called Natural Minerals Stellar Gaze Length and Strength Mineral Mascara. So if you're trying to lower your toxic load, mascara is a good place to start because it's right on your eyes. It goes into whatever you put on your eyes, it's going to go into your body. I mean, anything you put on your skin is going to go into your body, but you have an opening in your eye. So mascara is a good thing to replace. I have had a very difficult time replacing my foundation. It seems that the natural products, they just don't get my complexion quite right. Now, I'm going to share with you a lower toxic load foundation that I have used for a couple of years in different times of the year. This one is called Pure 4-in-1 Liquid. It's not the least toxic, but it has a lower toxic level. And the reason that I can't use it year round is that this is the darkest color. And I can use it, if you can see, it's like really one shade lighter than what my face looks like. So I can make this work if I mix it with, like if I put other like concealers that are, you know, a little bit darker in certain areas of my life or contour my face, I can make this work. But this foundation is buildable and it is good. Like it works well. It's just I wish that it came in a darker color. And they have a concealer that is great for highlighting, but this one right here, it works really well. In the wintertime, I can use this foundation. But I wish they would come out with a deeper color. This one is called Deeper Sombre is the color. They need one shade light darker for me. And I'm not even the darkest complexion. I'm pretty dark, but I'm not the darkest complexion. So if you're darker than me, don't even mess with this unless you're looking for something to use as a highlighter or something like that. But there are better options for that. But I do like the way this foundation feels. It's buildable, it stays on, and it is reliable. I just like it. And last but not least, I think this is one of my favorites. This is called Ellie's Best Fractionated Coconut Oil. And so this is the coconut oil that it stays liquid 24/7. I don't know how they make it. I don't know the science behind it. All I know is that I make my own creams for my body to moisturize my skin. And sometimes I just need a little bit of extra oil in whatever I grab out of the container. So I'll use a pump to mix with my moisturizer that I use, like especially if it's really cold or something and I need to break down the mixture that I made a little bit. So I'll grab a little bit of this. Also, this is good for if you're using essential oils. It's a great carrier oil. I also use this for massage, like if I massage my friends or my husband or something like that, or even massaging myself. This is a great oil for that. I don't use it on my hair or anything like that. It doesn't have the right consistency for me for that, but this is a great beauty oil, like just to use on your skin. And you can use it alone. But I like to use it with my shea butter mix that I make. So I like this. I don't use this to make my shea butter mix. I just use it as a help to my shea butter mix if it's needed. So I hope that makes sense. But I love this stuff. And I got this from Amazon, and I think it's like either $13 or $16. I can't remember. And it's hexane free, which is one of the things you want to look for. And it is cold pressed. Fragrance free, hypoallergenic, is non-greasy. It's not greasy. You would think it would be, but it's not. So those are my favorite products for right now that I absolutely love. I would recommend them to you. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you have used any of these products, I would love to hear what you think about them, and also share what some of your products are. I would love to hear what your products are that you use on a regular basis, because I'm always looking for things that are natural that work well, because those are far few in between on the marketplace. So anyway, y'all, thanks so much for watching, and I will talk to you all soon. Take care.